TikToker too? I don't know this park was this lit. Oh, he did. A TikToker and CP president? Who is it in this? Well, but anybody's gonna play this game. They don't have any sand. Chris Paul's gonna be a Hall of Fame school threat. Watch this. Look at my left hand. Wow, so inspirational. My last name is so inspirational, isn't it? So inspirational. Let's see how Chris Paul plays. Hey, bro, the two core jet bike. I need one of my homeboys to join up. Seemingly all I wonder. I need somebody to hop on and we're chilling. Come on, who wouldn't want to play Chris Paul? It'd be awesome. I don't care, bro. I'll play with the pro if I have to. I don't want to play against CP3. Honestly, I mean, bro, he's going to shoot this one court. Yeah, I think they lost. But I'm sure one. Man, I wish he had his own face creation. You know what? I don't think a TikTok was just in here. This stuff used to be lit. And I have a question. Why does Gamer Keezy have a YouTube logo, bro? He's just a TikToker. This dude's just a TikToker, bro. They give him. He's known for TikToking, so I don't know. Bro, what? I'm wrong, I'm playing against Chris Paul. And honestly, I think the reason why I'm getting into his park because he lives in Tucson. Oh no, Arizona at least. I got Steph Curry's park though. Oh, are they even? Oh yeah, they're in those. I'm so. They're like him. Where are they? I'm gonna see if somebody hops on if I dip. And guys, by the way, how I know it's Chris Paul? Look at the name. Like, how could this not be Chris Paul? Look at the name. See that? Huh. This took less 2 days. Playing against these kids earlier. Oh, yeah, the different builds. Bro, there'd be no reason A to live. Let's get it. So Chris Paul live in Arizona too, brother. I live in Arizona too. Yo, Chris Paul. Hey. I bet everyone just parked this in Arizona. I'm playing cap. But we're not giving this dude air at all. Like, bro, whoever, bro, he doesn't, oh. No, I'll play with two centers. We can run two centers. Oh! No, bro. No one's playing. Oof. I got on other court. Chris Paul's tricking me. Did he dip? Oh. Bet. No, I don't care. I can win a game. I'm chilling. I'm literally a pro. I don't care. No, it's like I lied, brother. I'm not playing with you. This dude Chris Paul plays 24 hours per day. Hold on, they're in the playoffs now. First time they made the playoffs. And I'm not even a fan of them, like, just saying. I'm a Bucks fan. I want them to play in the NBA Finals. I want Giannis to dunk on Chris Paul.
Yeah, 20 million less than what Jordan offered. Kemba literally lost tens of millions of dollars just to spite Michael Jordan. But at least Kemba just walked away and didn't let things get out of hand. Because one time, a teammate tried to end Jordan's career because he was tired of all the disrespect. Back in 1988, Michael Jordan was still chasing his first NBA championship, and he was hoping to win it with his best friend, Charles Oakley. So, when the Bulls ended up trading Oakley away,
bet.
Jordan was...
I don't care.
And there's no one better for him to take his anger out on than the guy that replaced his friend, Bill Cartwright. He started at the very first practice.
Oh, it's gonna be Bill Ambrose.
Started calling the dude
that boy Bill.
Saying that he sucked, he's always hurt. Things got so bad, Jordan gave Cartwright the nickname Medical Bill. And it didn't stop at name calling. During passing drills at practice, Jordan just kept whipping the ball at him, like they were playing dodgeball or something. And this drove Cartwright to his breaking point. He was about to snap. One more sign of disrespect from Jordan, he was gonna let him have it. Fast forward a couple of weeks, and it happened again. In a game against the Hornets,
I'm taking a little bit too long.
Nights of his career. So Jordan got up, and he told the entire team that Cartwright didn't belong in the NBA. And that was it. That was all Cartwright needed to hear. Cartwright gets Michael aside, and he says, "Look, if you ever do anything like that again, you will never play basketball because I'm going to break both of your legs." All right, just to put things into perspective a little bit, Bill Cartwright was 7'1" and 250 pounds. If he wanted to break Jordan's legs, he could have done it.
Battle.
Arthur Jordan would have won 6 rings with no legs. So, that talk that they had, he set Jordan straight. After that, $1 million.
I want to respect him.
The level of fear that he inspired in others.
I don't want to disrespect him. After that, but there's no way if I'm Michael Jordan, still really threaten me to break my legs. Okay, I'll respect you. Just don't break my legs, please.
The Cartwright didn't belong in the NBA. That was it. That was all Cartwright needed to hear. Cartwright gets Michael aside. And he says,
okay, I'll wait 2 more hours.
Alright, just to put things into perspective a little bit, Bill Cartwright was 7'1" and 250 pounds. If he wanted to break Jordan's legs, he could have done it. And, Arthur Jordan would have won 6 rings with
I'm
no legs.
I'm snaggy, Gary.
So, that talk that they had set Jordan straight.
Hey, bro, it is depressing how no one's in my stream, and I literally CP3's in my park. And I want to play against this dude. I'm the goat. Bro, but I'm about to call these dudes slow if they hop off.
One more loss for Charlotte. Their season was over. So, everyone thought the Hornets were done. Everyone except one player, Muggsy. Losing was not an option. This man is the shortest player in NBA history. At just 5'3". You think he's going to pass up a chance to beat Michael Jordan and win a championship? This man would go down as a legend. His career depended on this win. So in the fourth quarter of game 4, with the game tied, Muggsy Bogues dribbled up the court. With just a few seconds left on the clock, Muggsy was getting ready to take the game-winning shot. And that's when Michael Jordan stared Muggsy down and yelled, "Shoot it, you f***ing midget." Jesus, man. This man needs to chill a little bit. This isn't an Xbox 360 lobby. You can't be saying that. Cancel just reading the quote. Damn. As if being the shortest player in NBA history isn't hard enough. You gotta deal with MJ doing stuff like that? But I guess the trash talking worked, because...
Bro, if not Call of Duty 2, where, like, anyone's just gonna trash talk that, go kill yourself, kid. I did your mom.
Right here. Muggsy's miss was the only thing he could think about. I mean, he even went on to tell Johnny Bott, a Bulls assistant coach, that this miss against Jordan was the one moment that ruined his career. And, I mean, the stats back that up. Muggsy went from averaging 11 points a game just 5, and he was out of the NBA entirely by 2001. But I mean, if you gotta look at the bright side, at least Muggsy didn't turn into a meme, because there's a lot of moments in the NBA that get meme to hell. Like, what is even going on in this picture? How does this even happen? Oh, you want to hear more about that? Well, then click on this video right here. These are the NBA moments.
I swear that just hopped off. CP3
won. Have you ever seen this meme or this one?
Oh, I've definitely seen that one.
NBA? Have you ever seen this meme or this one or this one and wondered, what's the story behind this meme? Like, how did this happen? Well, these are the NBA moments that turned into memes. And Rajon Rondo came through with one of the weirdest memes I've ever seen. Back in 2019, Rajon Rondo decided to confess his love to Luka Doncic, and it got mean. Yeah, it was a game between the Mavs and the Lakers, and my man Luka was putting on a show. This man was hitting dunks, step back threes, 360 no-scoping dudes off the court. He was on fire, and right when Luka walked past Rajon Rondo, a meme was born.
Doncic, 25 points, 8 boards, 10 assists, and he had 16 of the 25 points in the third quarter.
Huh, I guess there's nothing weird about that. Rondo looking at a... Holy s***, did you see the way that he looked at his ass? Rondo wanted to tap that, no question. And guess what? Twitter turned this into one of the biggest memes I've ever seen. Yeah. That's what you get, Rondo. All right, hold on. Let me be honest. Can you really blame Rondo? I mean, come on. Who hasn't checked out Luka? What? Just me and Rondo? That's it? Who you guys?
Pause, bro. This dude is sick. Who hasn't checked out Luka? This dude sucks.
It's not like someone tried to end his career. Because for James Harden, he almost went blind. Was the 2019 playoffs. Harden's Rockets were facing the Warriors. And in game two, Draymond Green took things too far. Draymond's Harden's eyeballs. This man just had both of his eyes poked out, his eyelids cut, and he was an inch away from going completely blind. Just look at that fingerprint. Disgusting. And then Twitter had to go make it worse, turning this man into a meme. They're out here saying, oh, this man looks high. Oh, he's crying. Ridiculous. This man's a soldier. He kept on playing after this. Show Harden some
he
respect.
He looks high. Yeah, I gotta be...
Harden got roasted on Twitter. But... took that roast and turned it into a meme. Back in January 2021, the Utah Jazz were on a 6-game winning streak, but one NBA legend still wasn't enough. Because after Donovan dropped 36 points in a comeback win against New Orleans, Shaq tried to embarrass him on live TV.
I said tonight that you are one of my favorite players, but you don't have what it takes to get to the next level. I said it on purpose. I want you to hear it. What do you have to say about that?
But it turns out Donovan didn't care what Shaq had to say. And literally one word is all it took for a viral meme to be born.
What do you have to say about that?
That's it.
That's it?
That's it.
That's all it took. 5 letters. And that turned into one of the biggest memes of the season. And Twitter, they let Shaq hear it. They're showing Donovan the love he deserved. People even started making t-shirts with Hyde on them. But not every meme has to come from some disrespectful moment. Sometimes it's hard to mourn. Started thanking everyone who helped him along the way. And that's when, on live TV, KD said this.
Sacrifice for us?
Damn, Katie, man. It's supposed to be a happy moment. But,
where?
It's the next words that came out of Katie's mouth that turned into one of the biggest memes.
That was the machine. Oh, I'm going too low. Yeah, my love in Chris Paul's park. My mom.
He's like, I had another BMW before, and he's like, it wasn't that fast, but this.
Like, we go practice outside and play basketball.
What?
We practice outside. I gotta get down there.
I got a lot of stuff to do. I mean, we'll do it later, but
yes, sir. His shit was nice.
I'm not going outside, dude.
What?
Nothing. I got a new PS4 today.
Just let me in your house.
Why not? Knock. Yeah. What thought?
Yes.
The only way that you could be here if you were on your phone. I'm literally getting so bored. He's not safe phone.
It kills me how literally all the niggas are literally still in Porto Penasco, like. Literally, if you weren't at Connor's party, you were at Rocky Point. If you weren't there, my nigga, I don't know where you were.
I would drop you off.
Eh?
I was either. I'm going outside.